question about that as well. Is it the adjustment of the
is it this room here?
This row here. Yes, I'm next to my husband. I can sit back where I was.
Okay,
then
why
I
don't you sit and let me know how it is. I can't do it now because it will be in the pianist size.
thank you everybody for coming, and I'd like to extend a very warm welcome to everybody in the church and also our online audience who are listening to the live stream. And we've got people from all over the UK and also from overseas as well, lots of people from across the Atlantic listening to this concert, so that's really great. And it's also lovely to see so many familiar faces in the audience as well, some from the last time that we played here in May. So this is the Gustav Holst Ensemble's second live concert in Brackenbury this year, and we're very, very grateful to the Church of the Holy Innocents for allowing us to use this fantastic space. This time we're very excited to be joined by fantastic pianist Viv McLean for a beautiful programme of Mozart and Beethoven piano quartets. We thought it'd be interesting to programme these two works together because Mozart and Beethoven were contemporaries and they were actually composing at the same time. And Beethoven was in fact greatly influenced by Mozart throughout his career, being the junior to Mozart, and he was inspired by Mozart's wind quintet when he wrote Opus 16, which is the piano quartet that we are playing today. Before we start the performance, I'd just like to run through a few points of housekeeping for those of you that are in the church today. In the unlikely event of a fire, the main fire exit is at the back of the church through the double doors down there. In terms of the concert itself, if you need to leave early and you'd like to make a donation to help support the church and the ensemble, there's a collection basket at the back of the church. And finally, I just wanted to remind you to make sure that you've switched off your mobile phones, as this is a recorded event and we don't want to disturb everybody listening to the beautiful music. So we hope you enjoy the concert and thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. you so much for coming and supporting us. It's a real joy to be playing. We haven't done that many concerts since lockdown, and everyone feels like a real gift, so it's wonderful to see so many of you here. We're going to follow that with a piano quartet by Beethoven, which I'd never heard until Rachel invited me to play this concert. So I'm very grateful to Rachel for programming it, because it's a really, really beautiful piece. He was inspired by Mozart, and in fact, this is a transcription of a wind quintet. If you want to listen to this in another form, go and put Beethoven Opus 16 Wind Quintet into Spotify, and you can hear the original, which was in turn inspired by the Wind Quintet written by Mozart. It's in four movements. It begins with three and a half. The first two movements are linked.
It's a bit different.
Yeah. You'll hear a slow section followed by a fast section. And an absolutely exquisite lyrical second movement, which has lots of beautiful, beautiful tunes. It's Beethoven at his most lyrical, isn't it? This movement, absolutely gorgeous. And then quite a fun rondo to finish, which is it's a form where there's a theme, and you'll keep hearing the theme coming back over and over again. I'm sure many of you know this already, but just in case there are people in the audience who don't know what that is, you can enjoy hearing it return. And it's a very genial music for Beethoven. Obviously, we'll try and make it as extreme as possible, but this is actually quite in character. It's quite genial, isn't it? And the last movement's sort of fun. So anyway, I hope you enjoy this.
Thank you. Thank you.
huge thank you to my wonderful musicians, Viv, Claire and Lucy, for playing so beautifully today. I'd like to thank the church, so that's Father David Matthews and Hannah, for making this wonderful space available to use. Thank you also to Pavlos very much for all the filming and the live stream. And last but not least, I'd like to thank all of you for coming, both our in-person and online audiences. As you know, live music can only happen with your support, and thank you very much indeed for those of you that have already donated tonight. To those of you that haven't donated and would like to, there is a collection bucket at the back of the church, just around the corner, and we would really be grateful if you would just give something to help support this and future events. You can also make a donation online on the Eventbrite website where you register for tickets. If you go to the online viewing only with donation tickets, you can then retrospectively make a donation if you like the performance. And all proceeds are going to be split equally between the ensemble and the church. So the church has provided this space for free today. So any donations you give will go to the church. Finally, just a footnote to say, with COVID in mind, can you just make sure that you give each other space when you leave the church? Perhaps if you leave from the back rows first, that would be great. And if you could just leave any kind of conversations till you're sort of more or less outside the church, that would be amazing. So we look forward to seeing you at the next event. Thank you very much.